All right, everybody. Thanks for sticking around late into the evening and the weekday. We have one more amazing show for you tonight. And this one was done by another one of our grade 11 and 12 classes. And this one was not only written, workshop, revised by the class. It was directed, assistant directed, stage managed, lighting design, prop design, costume design, what else am I missing? Fight choreographed. Essentially everything that happens here, I was just sort of around and helping out where I could, but they ran the show. So this is truly their show. And I'm excited to share it with you now. All right, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy our final show of the evening. This is the best.
Checked in. the room, the collaboration. Abigail, would you be a dear and get my friend Sherry in your room? She'll be staying with us for a while. Of course, it's for Abigail. I can help you right here.
Oh, your eye. Are you okay?
It's nothing. All right, then. Well, before we get you into a room, I'm going to need to get you to sign in. Please, we'll only take a moment. Here on time, and today's devotional is very special as we have a new member. This is Sharon's first time joining us. Welcome, Sharon. My name is Joanna. You might seem nervous, but there's no need. You'll catch on easily. You seem brave. Samuel, I believe it is your turn to start us off this week, will you?
This morning, before picking green apples from the garden tree with Tavia, I had a moment of doubt. I thought, just for a moment, what if there was more out there in the real world? But then I remembered where my family was found, and I released that worry from my body. I should have never doubted the important work we do or the purpose we share together.
Share will be forgiven. What we share brings to fruition.
Thank you for bearing your soul to us, Lemuel. If nobody else feels compelled to confess, Abigail and I thought
actually,
we should.
I too have something I'd like to share. It has been 10 years since I've been formally recognized Cassidy. I don't know who I'd be or what I'd do without all of you. And without Mother. I just wish that the people beyond our walls, they knew what this felt like. To be bonded to this community beyond blood. I'm so, so grateful to share this purpose with you all. Thank you.
What is shared will be forgiven. What we share brings to fruition.
Who's Mother? When we are still, just be patient.
That was beautiful, Tavian. Thank you for sharing that sentiment with us.
Now for this activity, we're ready to get you in the burger after.
This is a game of trust. Each pair will decide between themselves who will be the blindfolded and who will be the catcher. The blindfolded partner will have to fully trust their catcher in order for this activity to be a success. But each partner holds equal responsibility. Do you understand?
Once you decide who's who and the blindfold is secure, you may start. You may stand one behind the other. Please do not rush it. Trust yourself, your partner, and your intuition. Don't be nervous. I've probably done this 100 times. It's just a trust fall. That was wonderfully done, everybody. Your utter devotion would inspire generations to come, and more importantly, make mothers sing like a loon. Adam, would you be a dear and get the gift for Sharon?
Oh, right, of course.
A gift?
For what? It's a devotional tradition. After someone's first devotional, they are considered a member of our community. Will you be joining us for brunch tomorrow? We're celebrating freshly with you.
I thought it was just a small brunch, at least that's what Abigail told me.
Abigail never really knows what she's talking about. Oh, bless her. Here. How does this make you feel more like one of us do? I think I found you that night for a reason. I just hope I can help you.
Celebration, of course.
Celebration?
Yes, she has an announcement.
What is it? Unfortunately, I don't know. I've been asking, you know, she's been very secretive about it.
Well, I guess it must be pretty important then.
Everything is important. You'll learn that with her, of course.
I think you should meet with Mother.
I don't know. I'm open yet, though. I don't want to step over her wishes.
I understand.
It's just you know how impatient she can get.
I know. Abigail!
There she is.
I'll see you later.
Okay. I'll see you later.
Coming, Mother!
Oh, bless her. She gets so excited over these things.
I guess you don't really know what's going on either, then.
No, I don't.
Oh, no, the time. I'm so sorry, Sharon. I told Diana I had to go help her in the yard.
Oh, can I come with you? Maybe I can help out?
Not this time. You need to stay inside and rest.
But, I mean, there's only so much resting I can do, and plus that room can get pretty boring.
All right, come on.
Maybe it...
great idea. Just let me know if you need anything.
Adam, Damien, will you please make sure Sharon gets her room safely?
No, really, it's okay. I can find my own way back now.
Please, we insist.
It's the only way the men's room back.
Take care of you.
She's growing skeptical. I'm worried.
I'm not, my dear. Did she finish the chalice?
Yes. I think so.
Then there's nothing to worry about. It's already in fruition.
But are you sure? If anything were to go wrong, it's just...
We've
so long. Relax, Pheasant. Your concern is meaningless. I have this all figured out.
Do you not trust
me? I do! Of course I do! My deepest apologies.
Then dismiss yourself.
Safe. Well, it belonged to my husband.
Sorry, I don't fully understand.
To put it simply, our marriage was never all that great. He would come home late at night, drunk as ever. And when he wasn't drinking, he was angry. Well, it wasn't safe anywhere. And as soon as I found out that I was pregnant, I knew I had to leave.
And you ran.
I had no choice but to. I had no reason to believe that he wouldn't have the child as he did me.
So you think he'll come looking for you?
I don't know, but I really would have put it past him.
I see.
I have this feeling that I haven't really gotten away from you yet.
I understand your worry, but I cannot stress how safe you are here. Mother sees you as one of her own. She would never let any harm befall you.
I know, it's stupid, but I can't help but worry.
It's not stupid. I'm sure you'll be fine, all the same.
Cautious until I know for sure. Sharon, you can't trust anyone. Not even me. Sharon, dear? Can I have a word with you? Yeah, sure. How are you feeling today? I'm all right. I haven't been getting much sleep lately, but aside from that, I seem to be doing okay. I was actually just headed on my way to breakfast.
I understand. Physically speaking, there is quite a lot of stress on me. I won't hold you long, but it is important to get your rest. You must keep your little girl.
It's just, it's difficult because, well, I've been having these strange dreams, they wake me up.
Well, what happens in these dreams?
Lately, I see someone dead. I don't know exactly. I can tell she's a woman, but that's all. And I don't feel fear. When she dies, I feel relief.
Curious. Well, maybe she could represent you, or rather something you're overcoming.
I don't know. I don't know if they're stress related, or maybe they hold more meaning.
It happens too much. It's not unusual for the brain to react in such a way. I can only urge you to come speak to me about that. I want to be a real mentor and guide for you in this life. Can you do that?
Maybe.
I hope so. But in the meantime, get your rest. I know you've had your fill of people trying to get you to rest, but it really is what's best for you. And if these dreams do persist, come back, and we will decide from together. Yes?
Yes, I will. Thank you.
Dreams are like telephone calls. They send and connect us, and reality is more than one. You and I both literally end on a metaphysical plane. The calls we make at night in our heads are like messenger dots, connecting us through multiple dimensions through the waking comprehension. Secrets are revealed. Worries about forthright, and if you look a little deeper, you might just see the end of everything.
Fallen like a baby bird, unfit for his nest. Is he? afraid he fell head first.
Oh.
There was nothing. And he broke his neck.
Such a shame. He's so young and his commitment here too. My heart just aches for him.
What do we do with?
Go fetch Tegan and Diana. Bring one of our finest ceremonial cloths and wrap them up neatly. The three of you mournfully, of course, take our sweet Lemuel up to the medical ward, where Joanna will confirm his death and the cause. Afterwards, gather up the rest of the Castile members and start preparations for the funeral ceremony. Formal attire is required. Tonight we celebrate his life. Now!
Mother, don't you think that we should notify the authorities? Report it to the police? I don't know. Do something?
Yes, of course.
I'll call the sheriff right away. You should hurry along now, too. There's much to prepare. Hurry on.
Go for it, dear brother Lemuel. go with you? I'm not sure I really want to be doing this or how to. Of course.
The youngest ones are the most expendable enemies.
her down.
Relax. Please, you're tired.
I don't care. Put her down now.
Tavian, would you bring Sharon back to her room, please?
No. No. No, I'm not going back. Get off me! I'm not going anywhere without her.
She's going to be fine, Sharon. You need to lie down.
I'm not leaving.
Sharon, I urge you to go back to bed.
I'm not going.
No! Why do you have to make this so difficult? Why do you care about this baby? It will live as a constant reminder of the harshness of our world, of your past. Poison root grown from a seed of violence and wrath. Is that what you want?
What did you do to her?
I have been waiting forever for this baby. And now I've shaped it into the perfect specimen.
What have you done?
Oh, I did nothing, dear. You did it for me.
Oh, God. Pull the drinks.
Yes. This whole time, you've been helping me push my plan to completion, and you have been none the wiser. Did you really think we cared for you? You're a means to an end, my dear. But now, we don't need you. This is about so much more than me or you or my vessel. This is the birth of a new generation, a species only the gods could think of. My prophecy and my legacy delivered to me a vessel. You, common wench, you have a purpose, so much meaningful purpose, even with your blood on my hands.
Let me have your little
up there and take a bow with everybody. Yeah. Everyone. Yeah.